Hello sustainable growers, Jonathan from Melbourne Aquaponics. In this video, we'll comment the little aquaponic setup of
Kartik,
one of my followers, who has done a really good job, I would say, at transforming a very small aquarium into a real, very small aquaponics setup. At one point, I had 7 aquariums in my very small teenager's room, and it was a lot of things going on into this room. The pumps were making some noise and I couldn't really sleep, but I was very happy to have all those fish around me. And the idea for me was to try to recreate the ecosystem that we had into those rivers. But the reality is that in an aquarium you don't recreate the whole ecosystem, you just take a little portion, a little picture of the ecosystem. And unfortunately, there is no real balance into the aquarium, which means that any food that you put into the aquarium at the end is going to create some ammonia and nitrates and then nitrates, and these nitrates are going to accumulate into the aquarium, into the water, and they're going to increase with the time. And therefore, in an aquarium, you need to renew the water every 3 weeks, 1 month, 2 weeks, well, depending on how you manage it, depending on the population you have and the quantity of food you put into the system. But basically, you still need to do some water changes. And when you got 7 aquariums, it's a lot of water changes. You have to do them quite frequently. So depending on the size of the aquarium, it can be a big job or it can be very small. But still, it's a certain quantity of workload. So once I realized that it was really possible to make those kind of setups, I could decrease the quantity of water change that I had to do into the aquariums. And it was a real relief because, as you know, the water change in an aquarium are a big job. So if you have some big aquariums, especially in freshwater, I would definitely recommend you to turn them into an aquaponic setup, because the fish tank by itself can stay the same, can keep your fish, whatever the temperature is, it's perfect. Just add a grow bed on top of it and you're gonna grow some food or some ornamental plants. But you're gonna decrease the quantity of water changes that you will have to make into your aquarium. So it's gonna be a real, real relief for you. So today we got someone who has designed a really good setup, and that's what we're gonna look at. We're gonna see how he transformed a nice little aquarium into a real small aquaponic setup. We're gonna see that obviously it's a first trial, so there are things that he could have improved. And I'm gonna give you my view on this setup. I'm gonna tell you what is good and what is bad from my point of view. And please, in the comment also, comment this setup and let him know exactly what you think of the aquaponic setup. But I think he deserves a lot of good comments, because at least he did something, he started something, and I think it's great. It looks good, you know. Could be better, but it's a good first step. So the first thing I noticed is that it's a very small fish tank. And, well, as you know, if you had the aquarium for a while, a little aquarium is very difficult to balance, right? I mean, when I say very difficult, I mean, you know, it's difficult to have the good bacteria to treat all those peak of nitrate and of ammonia that you're going to create when you feed your fish. So if you overfeed the fish, it's going to be a problem. You don't have this problem in a bigger scale aquarium. You have less fluctuations. So here, I think it's really good to convert this aquarium, but I would have started with an aquarium that was a little bit bigger. But still, you know, it's good because at least you did something and it looks amazing. If you have an aquarium and you still have to make all your water changes and you are a bit bored with it, I offer you a free support to make your own aquaponic setup and to convert your own aquarium into an aquaponic setup. So download it from the description just here below. So one of the points is that the grow bed is quite high compared to the height of the fish tank. So obviously the pump needs to work to push the water up to the grow bed. So it makes a bit of effort that is maybe unnecessary. Obviously, I understand you had the window at this area, at this place, and for you it was kind of obvious. You just have to put the little grow bed on the window and there you got the light. So I totally understand why you did it this way, and it works really well. But just from an energy point of view, you could have saved a bit of power if you reduced the height of the crowbed, if you put it in a position just a bit lower, just above the fish tank. The main point that I see, the main negative point, is that I don't see any bell siphon or any water high fluctuation. So maybe there is one, explain us, but here what I see is a constant flow level. And a constant flow level aquaponic setup is going to work at the beginning, but after a while you're going to have the bottom of the grow bed that is going to turn anaerobic. And once this part turns anaerobic, which means without oxygen, you're going to have some fermentation, so you are not going to have the good transformation of ammonia in nitrate and nitrate, because the aerobic bacteria are not going to be present. But the other problem you're going to have is that you are inside and it's going to smell very bad. So see how it goes, but what I would do, I would modify the grow bed to make sure that I would put a timer on the pump, on the water pump, and I will make sure that there is a water fluctuation into the grow bed. So if you don't know how to do that, there are two ways, right? The first way is to work with a bell siphon, but for this type of little setup, it's going to be very difficult, very tricky to make a little bell siphon. So I really recommend to use a timer. You put your pump on a timer, you make it work maybe every 15 minutes or every 5 minutes, up to you. I will make a special video about how to plug a timer pump on your aquaponic setup.
If you put your water pump on a timer, I would recommend to add a little air pump into your fish tank.
One of the good points is that you got very few fish, so I think there is a really good balance between the quantity of crow bed you have and the quantity of fish biomass. So I don't think you're going to have problem of feeding your fish too much and not being able to transform all the ammonia, except if you don't fix this problem of constant water level, which is going to turn your setup anaerobic, your grow bed anaerobic in a while. This setup is built on a tropical aquarium. That's really good to have a high temperature, right? Because for the bacteria, it's amazing. The bacteria are working way more, way faster, way better at high temperatures than at low temperature. The only problem you're going to have is that because it's tropical fish, I imagine you feed them with the fish food you find into the aquarium shop. Most of the time, this kind of fish food contains some colorants and sometimes some medicines or some different molecules. So just check what are the ingredients, because if you want to eat the lettuce, if you want to eat whatever you produce from this grow bed, just want to make sure you are not going to eat anything that could be harmful for you. I understand that's pet food, it's supposed to be safe for the fish, but what is safe for a little fish is not necessarily safe for you. Personally, I wouldn't eat the pet food that they sell into the aquarium shop, and I'm sure you wouldn't. And I'm not saying that when you have an aquaponic setup, you are eating the fish food of your fish. I'm just saying that be careful whatever chemicals can be into the fish food, because you may find them into the vegetables that you're going to eat later on. And finally, I would like to congratulate you, because I think you choose a really good media. The clay balls are really well adapted for those type of very small setups. You know that normally here we use coria, we use a volcanic rock as a media, which has a very high surface area, so which is perfect for the bacteria. But in a small aquaponic setup as you have, the cost is not a problem, because here if we don't use clay balls, it's mainly because of the cost, right? It costs extremely, it's very expensive when you have a big setup. But in a small setup, such as the one you have, it's not such a big investment. So you have this kind of media, it's working really well, very efficient, and it looks good. So I think you made a really good choice. I would have done the same. And when I designed some very small setups, ornamental setups, I most of the time use clay balls as well. So that's all the comments I have to give you. Well, obviously there are more things to say, but in this video I think I give you already a few of them. If you are watching this video and if you have some comments about this lovely aquaponic setup, please give a comment below the video and let him know how we could improve it. And please give him some good comments, because he needs to have some good encouragement, because he's done a really, really good job. So if you want to do the same kind of things, if you want to transform your aquarium into an aquaponic setup, don't forget that you can have access to a free guide to transform your aquarium into an aquaponic setup, or to build a new aquaponic setup from scratch. So just get it from the description of the video just below, and I see you in the next one. Bye bye.
Thank you so much for watching the video. I really hope you enjoyed it.
Don't forget to get your free gift from this screen. You can also leave me a comment below the video, subscribe to the channel and see my last video. I really hope to see you soon and I wish you a fantastic success with aquaponics. Have a good crop!